twin islands of Saint Kitts and Nevis are known for their lush rainforest and emerald shores. But access to fresh water is becoming a real problem for this jewel in the Caribbean Sea. 2023 saw the country's driest rainy season on record. It shows how drought and climate crisis are posing a serious challenge to traditional ways of life.
Fresh water supply has been a serious concern for our citizens of Saint Kitts and Nevis. The forecast has predicted that the increase in dry spells will continue.
With water demand also expected to double over the next 10 years, can drought forecasting technology help these islands adapt? Almost 20 years ago, the government of Saint Kitts and Nevis shut down the water-intensive commercial sugarcane industry that had dominated the national economy for over 300 years. Since then, the country has focused on expanding tourism and diversifying agriculture.
For that to happen, it requires us having a steady supply of water to feed not just within the tourism sector, but also within the agriculture sector.
But the islands depend almost entirely on rainwater to grow food. And over the past 20 years, drought has become a serious problem for farmers.
Once ago, you could have planted and depend and sure that you're going to get rain and you're going to get your food watered. But now, you don't see it happen. It's less rain. I used to wonder what they say about climate change, but I've been into it, I've seen it.
To help farmers like Naomi adapt to these changes, the Saint Kitts and Nevis government, in partnership with UNEP's Climate Technology Center and Network and HR Wallingford, has developed a drought forecasting system.
It presents a forecast in terms of what is projected to happen, primarily looking at temperature and rainfall, which are the two main drivers to make decisions when it comes to the type of crops that you grow.
The system combines data from satellites, climate models, the St. Kitts Meteorological Station, and strategically placed sensors across the island. And in addition to sharing information through their website and daily news broadcasts, the meteorological department updates farmers directly via WhatsApp.
If I have more information, I will be better prepared, as in what to plant. To me, the more information I get, the better it is for me.
The forecasting tool offers drought risk maps, assessments of current and future water resources, and free access to climate data from satellites and weather models. And it has applications far beyond the agricultural sector, helping government officials, water resource managers, and emergency services to make informed decisions.
Data is what drives decisions. And as a small island developing state, a very vulnerable small island developing state, we need to make efficient use of the resources that we have.
Small island developing states, or SIDS, are responsible for less than 1% of global greenhouse gas emissions. And yet, they are among the countries most impacted by climate change. Over 70% of SIDS are currently at risk of water shortages. The UN Climate Technology Center and Network hopes to share drought forecasting learnings from Saint Kitts and Nevis with island nations facing similar water management issues across the Caribbean and beyond.
Small island developing states such as Saint Kitts and Nevis face a unique set of climate-related challenges. So addressing these challenges requires tailored, sustainable strategies and often external support due to the limited financial and technical capacity from SIDS.
Through targeted and low-cost investments, countries like Saint Kitts and Nevis can better adapt to and mitigate the worst impacts of a future affected by climate change.
If you don't learn to adapt in the near future, everybody hungry, everybody starved. So we just got to adapt to the situation.
It really requires everyone being a part of the process. The time for action is not tomorrow, but now.
Every fraction of a degree matters.